monetary point of view, I believe that based on Salem County having a fairly stable population base, that, and it's been this way since I was last county cluster, now that the justice position is being combined with county council, you're going to save money with regard to your salary and wage paying the adjuster. You're not going to pay the adjuster anymore. The adjuster itself. And I think what you ought to consider doing is taking staff down to regular part-time on a 20-hour-per-week basis. And I don't know what the number ends up being, Katie.
Yeah, the check was Karen,
you
remember,
just to help with that. Yes. Now, the OE itself, the number, there are two, as I saw it on the computer screen, there are two adjuster numbers. One's an OE and one's an S&W. Salary and wage. So the S&W would be the one to get rid of the adjuster compensation and then go regular part-time at that time.
Now, if she's social service, are we able to do that? Can you look into the legalities of that?
Yeah, I can look into it because I also, just on the surface, I need to have a better understanding of the scope of work that's changing. And that's going to help guide.
Okay.
There isn't going to be a change in the amount. I'm saying that on a 20-hour per week basis, the person's going to be able to get it done, or I'll fill the volume at my law office. So that's my recommendation.
Okay.
Yeah, I think
$44,000 is a salary, and then $10,000 that we have to pay Ken Miller. So $44,000, you know.
So you're saying there are two people in our office?
Only during the business, when it's our turn to do the business rotation for it.
Which is hard. That's needed when that
people. Right. We hired a temporary employee to go through that process.
Right.
In the past, the county has shifted those responsibilities to other counties that we're willing to cover with the business. Judge Curio said this past time that it was time for Salem County to step up, but particularly doing that, and handled it well.
Let me ask you this. Didn't I see some positions that were open who were at the jail that were clerk type positions?
Yes.
Could we take that person, instead of her losing her full-time status, and put her half there and half there, so that part-time is the adjuster's office and part-time is the sheriff? And I hate to see her lose her benefits.
Yeah.
Right, and
that, I don't know if the sheriff is going to
I'm assuming if she goes part time, there may be unemployment benefits involved. A little cost there.
I mean, I don't know what the number effect is going to be on you,
right.
So you're going to have to look.
Right.
And I know I've given you late
yes.
notice on it.
Yes. So the OE for that you're saying can be reduced as well. Right now we have it at $24,000.
That's a good job.
No, I'm not sure about the OE.
Okay.
I don't know the office call.
Okay.
On the cost of the office.
Right.
See, I don't know how you're allocating that building with the space they've taken that building was.
Okay. The Commission on Women, I knew that there was a number in there, and so I was looking back, and that line item last year was funded $1,750, and it looks like there was pins or an award or something frivolous. So, you know, there's money there that maybe instead of those items, you know, this year. I mean, I have, I think, $1,500 in there in that line item, so maybe it could be used for, you know, if that's something that you want to consider.
Okay.
Make a motion. Make a motion, we adjourn.
Second.
I have a motion second. All in favor?